Specialist here at Mo Valley, and I'm super excited to introduce our Spelling Bee participants for 2016-17. We will get started here in just a few minutes. I told the spellers this yesterday, we had a quick run through and we had a little practice, and I told them, because a lot of them were really nervous, I told them that we're all super proud of them. They're our top spellers in 3rd, 4th, and 5th grade, so they're already winners just being here on the stage. So we're really proud of all of you guys, really. Y'all did fantastic in your classroom bees. Yeah. I would like to extend gratitude and thanks to our judges today who volunteered their time. Our head judge is Mrs. Kim Demick. Our literacy support teacher, Ms. Eakin, and our compliance coordinator, Ms. Rode. Thank you for coming today. I also would like to thank our pronouncer, Mr. Mark Dimick. Thank you. And then Ms. Rodriguez, thank you too for being here as a volunteer and helping put all this together. Last but not least, I want to thank all of you family members, because I know you guys have spent lots of time studying all of those words, so thank you for helping your children.
Everybody and welcome. I just want to start by going over a couple of the real basic rules. I think you all know how a spelling bee works. When it's your turn, step to the microphone. I will pronounce your word. You are strongly encouraged, you're not required, but you're strongly encouraged to repeat the word back to me or back to the judges, so that we can be sure that we're both talking about the same word. All right, because if I say toothpaste and you start to spell suitcase, well, that's wrong. Okay, which brings us to the most important rule is, once you start spelling, every letter you say counts. You cannot unsay a letter. So be sure before you start that we're both talking about the same word. If you have, let's say, a long word, and maybe you get confused in the middle of your spelling and you want to start over, that is allowed, but you cannot change any of the letters you've already said. Okay, you cannot unsay a letter. If your word is cat and you say K, oh, I mean C-A-T, sorry, you said the K, it counts. Everybody clear on that? Okay, what questions are you allowed to ask me once I say your word? You can ask me to use it in a sentence. You can ask me for a definition. You can ask me the part of speech. You can ask me the language of origin, and you can ask me to repeat the word. All of these may help you to spell the word correctly. If you spell your word correctly, I will say that is correct. You take your seat, and the next speller comes to the microphone. If you are incorrect, you will hear this sound, and that means it's time for you to exit the stage and go get your certificate. The one exception to that is at the very end of the bee, when we're down to our final two or three spellers. If at that point you're incorrect, we're going to ask you to remain on stage. The reason for that is the winning speller has to spell a word in a round all by himself. And if he's incorrect, when we start a new round with the other spellers, get to rejoin the contest. So at the very end of the bee, and we'll give you a heads up when this comes, then you don't exit the stage immediately on an incorrect spelling. Twine.
Twine. T-W-I-N-E. Twine.
Correct. And when it's your turn to spell, just step right to the microphone. You don't have to wait for me to call you. Nifty.
Nifty. N-I-F-T-Y.
Correct. Your word is plural noun, monkeys. The word is monkeys.
Oh. N-O-N-K-E-Y-S.
Correct. Contract.
Contract. C-O-N-T-R-A-C-T. Contract.
Correct. your word has a near homonym, so when that happens, I'm going to pronounce the word, and then I'm going to give you the part of speech and the definition. So that way, we can distinguish it from the word that it might be confused with. So your word is belief. It's a noun. It means when trust or confidence is placed in a person or thing. Belief.
Belief. B-E-L-I-F-E. Belief.
Belief is spelled B-E-L-I-E-F. Janitor.
Janitor. G-E. Wait. Can you repeat the word?
Janitor.
Janitor. J-A-N-I-T-O-R.
Janitor is spelled J-A-N-I-T-O-R. Observe.
Observe. O-B-S-E-R-V-E. Observe.
Correct. Anteater.
Anteater. A-N-T-E-A-T-E-R. Anteater.
Correct. Elderly.
Elderly. E-L-D-E-R-L-Y.
Correct. Okay, your word could be confused with a similar word. The word is portable. It's an adjective. It means light enough to be carried. Portable.
Portable. P-O-R-T-A-B-L-E. Portable.
Correct. Timidly.
Timidly. Can you please repeat the word?
Timidly.
Can I have a definition?
In a way that is not brave or courageous.
Timidly. T-I-M-I-T-L-Y, timidly.
Timidly is spelled T-I-M-I-D-L-Y. Okay, your word has a near homonym. The word is massive. It's an adjective. It means weighty or heavy.
Massive. M-A-S-S-I-V-E. Massive.
Correct. Trance.
Trance. T-R-A-N-C-E. Trance.
Correct. Flexible.
Flexible. F-L-E-X-I-B-L-E.
Correct. Teaspoon.
T-E-A-S-P-O-O-N.
Correct. Climbed.
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 C-L-I-M-E-D. Climbed.
Climbed is spelled C-L-I-M-B-E-D. Okay, your word has a homonym. The word is knitting. It's a verb that means the act of making something, such as clothing, from interlacing yarn using your hands or machine needles. Knitting.
Knitting. K-N-I-T-T-I-N-G. Knitting.
Correct. Deadline.
Deadline.
D-E-A-D-L-I-N-E. Deadline.
Correct. Passage.
Passage. P-A-S-S-A-G-E.
Correct. Okay, your word could be confused with a similar word. The word is complaints. It's a plural noun. It means expressions of unfairness. Complaints.
Complaints. C-O-M-P-L-A-I-N-E-D.
Complaints is spelled C-O-M-P-L-A-I-N-T-S. Nonsense.
Nonsense. N-O-N-S-E-N-S-E. Nonsense.
Correct. Laundry.
Laundry. L-A-U-N-D-R-Y. Laundry.
Correct. Your word could be confused with a similar word. The word is lodging. It's a noun. It means a temporary place to stay.
Lodging.
Lodging.
Definition, please.
A temporary place to stay.
Lodging. L-O-D-G-I-N-G.
Correct. Okay, your word has a homonym. The word is veins. It's a plural noun. It means tubes that carry blood from different parts of your body to your heart. Veins.
Can I get the definition?
Tubes that carry blood from different parts of your body to your heart.
Can I get a sentence?
Yes. The marathon runner loved the feeling of her blood coursing through her veins as she ran.
Veins. V-A-N-E-S. Veins.
Veins is spelled V-E-I-N-S. Mountain.
Mountain.
M-O-U-N-I-T-A-N-S.
Mountain is spelled M-O-U-N-T-A-I-N.
And that's it.
Okay, and that's it for round one. Judges, we're going to continue with word number one. Hooves. Oh, I'm sorry. Your word could be confused with a similar word. The word is hooves. It's a plural noun. It means curved, hard coverings that protect the feet of an animal, such as a horse or a goat. Hooves.
Can you please repeat it for me, please?
Hooves.
Hooves.
And I have two pronunciations. It's hooves or hooves.
H. O-O-P-S.
Hooves is spelled H-O-O-V-E-S. Indicate.
I-N-D-I-T-I-C-I-N-D.
Indicate is spelled I-N-D-I-C-A-T-E. Performance.
Performance. May I have the definition, please?
A public presentation as of a dramatic work.
Can I have an example, please?
Jennifer bought a ticket to a matinee performance of Giselle.
Okay, let's see. P-O-R-F-A-N-E.
Performance is spelled P-E-R-F-O-R-M-A-N-C-E. Biology.
Biology. B-I-O. May I repeat it again?
Biology.
B-I-O-G-L-Y.
Biology is spelled B-I-O-L-O-G-Y. Okay, your word has a homonym. The word is clause. It's a noun. It means a group of words in a sentence that has its own subject and verb.
Clause. C-L-A-U-S-E.
Correct. Specific.
Specific. S-P-E-C-I-F-I-C.
Correct. Bemused.
B-E-M-U-S-E-D.
Correct. Invisible.
Invisible. I-N-V-I-S-I-B-L-E. Invisible.
Correct. Vocabulary.
Vocabulary. V-O-C-A-B-U-L-A-R-Y. Vocabulary.
Correct. Your word is contestants, the plural noun, contestants.
Contestants. C O N T E S T E N C.
Contestants is spelled C O N T E S T A N T S. Failure.
Failure. F-A-I-L-U-R-E.
Correct. Okay, your word has a near homonym. The word is beckon. It's a verb. It means to appear inviting, to attract.
B-E-C-K-O-N.
Correct. Fortune.
Fortune. F-O-R-T-U-N-E. Fortune.
Correct. Dimension.
Dimension?
Dimension.
Dimension. D-I-M-E-N-S-I-O-N. Dimension.
Correct.
Caterpillar. Caterpillar.
C-A-T-E-R-P-I-L-L-A-R.
Caterpillar.
Correct. Typo.
Say that again.
Typo.
Definition.
A tightly stretched cord or wire on which acrobats perform.
Can you repeat the word again?
Typo. Typo.
Can you repeat the word again?
Typo.
T-Y-P-O-P-E.
Typrope is spelled T-I-G-H-T-R-O-P-E. Okay, your word could be confused with a similar word. The word is applause. It's a noun. It means approval publicly expressed as by clapping hands. Applause.
Applause. A-P-P-L-A-U-S-E. Applause.
Correct. Innocent.
Innocent. I-N-N-O-C-E-N-T.
Correct.
That's
the end of the round. Okay, first spelling. Esteem.
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 Esteem. E-S-T-E-E-O.
Correct. Inlet.
Could you please repeat?
Inlet.
Inlet. I-N-L-E-T. Inlet.
Correct. Microscope.
Microscope. M-I-C-R-O-S-C-O-P-E.
Correct. Auction.
Auction. A-U-C-T-I-O-N. Auction.
Correct. Okay, your word could be confused with a similar word. The word is thicket. It's a noun. It means a dense growth of shrubbery or small trees. Thicket.
Thicket. T-H-I-C-K-E-T-T.
Thicket is spelled T-H-I-C-K-E-T. Mildew.
Mildew. M-I-L-D-U-E.
Mildew is spelled M-I-L-D-E-W. Okay, your word could be confused with a similar word. The word is bushel. It's a noun. It's a unit of dry measure used in the United States.
Bushel. B-U-S-H-E-L. Bushel.
Correct. Sediment.
Say it again, please.
Sediment.
Definition, please.
Material or a mass of material deposited as by water, wind, or glaciers. Sediment.
Sediment. S-E-D-I-M-E-N-T. Sediment.
Correct. Peculiar.
Peculiar.
Peculiar. Peculiar.
P-E-C-U-L-I-A-R. Peculiar.
Correct. Clodhopper.
Clodhopper. C-L-O-D-H-O-P-P-E-R.
Correct. Okay, your word could be confused with a similar word. The word is quashed. It's a verb. It means to put an end to. Quashed.
Can you repeat it?
Quashed.
Quashed. Q-U-A-S-H-D.
Quashed is spelled Q-U-A-S-H-E-D. Dandruff.
Dandruff?
Dandruff.
D-A-N-D-R-I-F-T.
Dandruff is spelled D-A-N-D-R-U-F-F. And that is the end of the round. Keep going with word 138. Cutlery.
Cutlery?
Cutlery.
C-U-T-L-E-R-Y.
Correct. Okay, your word could be confused with a similar word. The word is gnarled. It's an adjective. It means warped or twisted with. Or as if with knots.
G-N-A-R-L-E-D. Gnarled.
Correct. Okay, your word has a near homonym. The word is equestrian. It's an adjective. It means of, relating to, or featuring horseback riding. Equestrian.
Can you repeat the word, please?
Equestrian.
N-E-Q-U. S-T-R-E-N.
Equestrian is spelled E-Q-U-E-S-T-R-I-A-N. Bedraggled.
Repeat the word.
Bedraggled.
Bedraggled. B E D R A G G L E D.
Correct. Paisley.
P A I S L E Y.
Correct. Precursor.
Say the word again, please.
Precursor.
Definition, please.
A forerunner.
Precursor.
P R E C U R S O R.
Correct. Infuriating.
Infuriating. I N F U R I A T I N G.
Correct. Okay, your word could be confused with a similar word. The word is coronet. It's a noun. It means a small crown. Coronet.
Coronet. C O R O N E T.
Correct. And that is the end of the round. We are down to 7 spellers. Let's go to word number 176. Vulpine.
Vulpine. V U L P I N E.
Correct. Honolulu.
Honolulu. H O N O L U L U. Honolulu.
Correct. Neutron.
Neutron. N-U-E-T-R-O-N.
Neutron is spelled N-E-U-T-R-O-N. Catastrophic.
C-A-S-T-R-O-P-H-I-C.
Catastrophic is spelled C-A-T-A-S-T-R-O-P-H-I-C. Mahogany.
Say the word again, please.
Mahogany.
M, mahogany. M-A-H-O-G-A-N-Y, mahogany.
Correct. Avalanche.
Repeat.
Avalanche.
Avalanche. A-V-A-L-A-N-C-H-E. Avalanche.
Correct. Perpetrator.
Perpetrator?
Perpetrator.
Perpetrator.
P-E-T-P-E-R-A-T-O-R?
Perpetrator is spelled P-E-R-P-E-T-R-A-T-O-R. Similar word. The word is 20. It's an adjective. brownish orange to light brown color.
20.
20.
20.
20.
T-O-N-E.
20 is spelled T-A-W-N-Y. Demolish.
Demolish. D-E-M-O-L-I-S-H.
Correct. Frustrated.
Frustrated?
Frustrated.
Frustrated. F-R-U-S-T-R-A-T-E-D. Frustrated.
Correct. Okay, we are done with our five two spellers. Our two that went out this round are tied for third place, so give them a round of applause. We're done with our final two spellers. We are ready to continue. Your word is bereft.
Say it again, please.
Bereft.
Definition, please.
Deprived or robbed of the possession or use of something. Bereft.
Say it again, please.
Bereft.
Bereft.
Bereft. I have two pronunciations, bereft or bereft.
B-E-R-E-F-T.
Correct. Okay, your word has two pronunciations. I'm going to give them both to you. The word is Ian or Eon.
Using a sentence.
Carla estimated that she had been waiting for the bus for at least an eon.
Eon. E-O-N.
Correct. Okay, we are at the end of that round. We keep going. Sectional.
Say it again.
Sectional.
Repeat the word, please. Definition, please.
Made up of sections to be added or reduced at will. Sectional.
Say the word again one more time, please.
Sectional.
S-E-C-T-I-O-N-A-L.
Correct. Oddity.
Repeat.
Oddity.
Use an assignment, please. Please.
Sophia's mother liked to remark that a man who could cook dinner for himself was an oddity.
Oddity. O-D-I-T-Y. Oddity.
Oddity is spelled O-D-D-I-T-Y. Don't go anywhere. Okay, we now enter a single word round with our one remaining speller. If he gets this word correct, he will be declared the champion. If he is incorrect, we begin a new round with both of our spellers from this previous round. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Your word is combination.
Combination. C-O-M-B-I-N-A-T-I-O-N. Combination.
We have a chance.
And our tie, third place, we have one trophy, but we'll order another one for the other person. We have a tie, Michael C. His last name is somewhere, Chukwuminiki. And Haris Ahmed. Yay! You guys want to hold your certificates and parents can come take pictures of our winners. Anybody wants to take pictures? If for some reason Ethan can't or declines to do the district fee, then Dan will be our representative.